So today we are going to start our topic that is representation of graphs. This is our today's lecture. There are several ways to represent a graph, and in this section we shall learn three important types of representing a graph. And the first one is adjacency representation. Adjacency list representation, and this is our first type. And in this we will have, let G is a simple graph, then G can be represented by its adjacency list, which contains the vertices that are adjacent to each vertex of the graph. And if G be any directed graph, the adjacency list of G will contain all the vertices that are the terminal vertices of edges starting at each vertex of the graph. Now, what they are saying? How to find out the adjacency list? For this, we need to take a graph. Plot this graph here. So this is the graph we have. So this is our first vertex, that is A, and this is vertex B, this is vertex C, and this is vertex D, and this is vertex E. This is your first graph, that is G1, and this is undirected graph, and join this edge also, that is DB, and the required adjacency list will be. Now the adjacency list will be determined with the help of this table. We will take the vertex and adjacent vertices will be written in second column. The first vertex is A, B, C, D, and E. So A to E we have vertices, and adjacent vertices are, which are the vertices adjacent to A? So adjacent to A is only the vertex B. Now the adjacent vertices to B, adjacent vertices mean the there is a direct edge between the vertex B and the vertex which is adjacent. So there is a direct edge between B and C, B and A, B and D, D and E. So adjacent vertices are A, C, D and E. Similarly, we will have in case of C, that is B and D, and in case of D, that is B, C and E, and similarly we will have D and B. This is the case when we have undirected graph. Now you can have a directed graph also. So for the directed graph, you can plot this figure. So this is your vertex, that is B. This is your vertex. This is also vertex A. And this is C, this is D, and this is E. So there is an directed edge here. This is the directed edge. And similarly, B is connected with D also with the help of a directed edge. And this is a directed edge. And we will have C and E, both are connected here. So this is A, and D is also connected with the help of direct edge. This is also connected, and we will have a loop around C. So this is the loop, and C and E are multiply, C and E have multiple edges, ek se zyada edges hain yahan par. So like this. Now you can find out the okay, one more thing is there. C and E is also connected here with the help of directed edge, and there is a loop around B also, and there is the multiple edge between A and C. So this is the multiple edge. So this is the directed graph, and name it as G2. So the adjacent list can be determined. In the first column, we will have a vertex, and that is initial vertex actually, and this is the terminal vertices. So for the adjacency list, we require terminal vertices in second column, and initial vertices are A, B, C, D, E. Now the terminal vertices, which are the edges started with A, जो ए से स्टार्ट हो रहे हैं और बी पर खत्म हो रहे हैं, जौन से भी एजेस पर वो खत्म हो रहे हैं वो हमने लिखने. ए से बी एज है तो टर्मिनल वर्टेक्स इज देयर. ए टू सी इज एन एज, दिस इज द एज, सो टर्मिनल वर्टेक्स. ए टू डी इज एन एज, टर्मिनल वर्टेक्स. ए टू ई, दैट इज द टर्मिनल वर्टेक्स. सिमिलरली बी इज कनेक्टेड विद बी इटसेल्फ, सो देयर इज द टर्मिनल वर्टेक्स. And one edge is also there that going from B, and it is striking to the vertex D. So terminal vertex is D. Similarly, that is C, A, and E. This is a B, C, D, and this is a B and D. So this is the adjacent list of graph G2. So this is the first representation. Now the second representation is adjacency matrix representation. So adjacency matrix representation of graphs. So in this we will have a graph G with the vertices edges and edges, and this is a simple graph with n vertices. The adjacency matrix is denoted by AG, and this is will be the matrix A, I, and J. The matrix will be an n by n matrix, where the A, I, J will be written as 1 and 0 if VI, VJ are adjacent. So the matrix value will be taken as 1 if there is a direct edge between the pair of vertices, and 0 otherwise. 0 otherwise mean when there is no direct edge between the pair of vertices, the value will be taken as 0. So this is the meaning of adjacency matrix. And this is our first type, and write down the plot the graph. The graph is this one. This is the undirected graph we are taking, and these are the vertices of the graph, and the vertices are v1, v2, v3, this is v4, and this is v5. Now 5 vertices are there. It means your matrix will be 5 by 5. So you can write down the adjacency matrix of the graph. The graph is named as G1. So AG1 will be 5 by 5 matrix, and the vertices are v1, v2, v3, v4, and v5. Similarly, v1, v2, v3, v4, and v5. So when there is a direct edge, then we will take 1 value, and when there is no direct edge, you will take 0 value. Now you just see, this is the v1. So there is no edge of v1 with v1. If there is a loop, it means V1 is joined with V1 with the help of an edge, then the value will be taken as 1. Now, V1 is joined with V2, so 1 is there. V1 is joined with V3, so 1 you will take. V1 is not joined by the help of an edge with V4, so 0 value, similarly 1 value. Now this is the process of writing down the other values of the matrix. So 1 0 0 1 1, and that will be 0 0 1 0 0 1 1 0 1 1 0. This is the way of writing down the adjacency matrix. Now let us move further. Now suppose the graph is a directed graph, G is a directed graph with the vertices set V and edges set E, and the plot of the graph is like this. You can plot the graph here. So this is a graph. This is a directed graph even. So V1, V2, V3, V4, and this is V5. And plot the edges. All the edges will be plotted here. And all the edges are directed. So it means one vertex is striking towards the other vertex. So this is the directed graph, and name of the graph is G2. And how to write down the adjacency matrix? AG of this, when the graph is a directed graph. That will be 1 and 0. There, if there is an edge, if there is an edge with the initial vertex VI and terminal vertex BJ. So if there is no edge, and then the value will be 0. So this is the way to plot, way to write on the adjacency matrix. There will be A, G2, and the vertices are V1, V2, V3, V4, and V5. Similarly, V1, V2, V3, V4, and V5. So you can write down the values here. Now you just see V1 to V1, there is no direct edge. So that is 0. Now V1 is starting and going to V2. So V1 is striking to V2. So 1 will be the value. Similarly, V1 is going to V3 with the help of a direct edge. So that will also be 1. And V1 is there, and V1 is also, V1 is not going to V4. Just see, V4 is actually going towards V1. Just see the arrow. So the value will be 0 here. Similarly, V1 to V5 will also be 0. So you can write down the other values also. And now, V2 to V1 is 0. And that is 0, that is 1, this is 0, and this is also 0. Now V3 only is striking towards V4. So 1 will be the value in case of V4, otherwise all the values will be 0. Similarly, you will write down on the fourth row values, and V4 is only striking to V1. So this is 1, other values are 0, but V4 is striking to V5 also. This is 1 also. Now the last will be V5 is striking to V1 and V2. So 1 1, all the remaining values will be 0. So this is the adjacency matrix in the case of a directed graph. Now the adjacency matrix can also be written in the case of a directed graph. When the directed graph is having a multiple edges, now this is the vertex B. And similarly, we will have a vertex A, and this is a vertex C, and this is a vertex E and vertex D. So you can connect D and connect E with D. Similarly, connect A with E. With the help of direct edges, you will connect. Now B is also connected with D, is with C, and this is there. Now draw this directed graph. It is here. So E is connected with C here. So this can be connected with the help of multiple edges. Here we have multiple edges, and this is a loop around B also. So now this is going towards this edge is not here. Remove this edge between C and D. There is no edge between C and D. So this is the graph we have, and there are multiple edges. There is also a loop around C. So now you can plot the graph, and the graph for this is that will be A, and name of the graph is G3. So AG3 will be written like this. The vertices are A, B, C, D, E, and A, B, C, D, E. Now you just see there is no edge from A to A. So this is a 0, and A to B there is an edge, and there is an edge from A to C. Similarly, A to D is an edge, and A to E is an edge.
So this is we are doing. So you can plot the graph, and that is plot the matrices. The adjacency matrix AG3 will be having the second row element, that is 0, 1, 0, 1, 0. Similarly, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1. And that there is no edge from D to D. And then there is no edge starting from the vertex D to B, D to A, D to C, D to D, and D to E. So all the elements of fourth row are zero because there is no direct edge which is starting from the vertex D. Now, the last row elements are 0, 1, 1, 0. So this is the adjacency matrix in the case of graph G3. Now, if we have a graph with multiple edges and the graph is an undirected graph, then how to write down the adjacency matrix? Plot this graph. This is the multigraph again. So this graph contains four vertices, V1, V2, V3, V4, and you can give the name to the graph, that is G4. Now there are multiple edges in this graph. And just see how to write down the adjacency matrix in the case of this multigraph. The vertices are V1, V2, V3, V4. So V1, V2, V3, V4 is there. V1, V2, V3, V4 is there. And just see, there is no edge from V1 to V1. So it will give you zero. So V1 to V2, there are three edges. One, this is one, this is two, and this is three. So the value will be three here. This is important. And the edges between V1 and V3, no edge between V1 and V3. So it will give you zero. And similarly, it will have two. Similarly, V2 to V1 is 3, 0, 1, 1, and 0, 1, 1, 2. And this is 2 because V4 to V1, there are two edges. V4 to V1, 1 and 2.
Excuse
So
me,
it
sir,
is
your
a.
screen is not visible.
Okay. I think internet stopped working. Wait for 2 minutes. Let me check. ये अभी बंद हुआ है?
यस सर,
यस यस सर। बस बेटे 2 मिनट रुकिए, मैं इंटरनेट चेक कर लेता हूँ। इंटरनेट स्टॉप्ड वर्किंग एक्चुअली। तो क्या लो आप लोग बाद में क्लास लगा पाएंगे आज? विल यू बी फ्री इन द आफ्टरनून
या सर,
एट व्हाट टाइम?
सर 2 o'clock।
उसके बाद कितने बजे फ्री हैं?
सर 3 to 4 हमारा लेक्चर है लीड
फोर टू
स्टूडेंट्स
फाइव
का, तो भी है ओएस का
फोर टू फाइव
सर 4 to 5 सर नहीं हो पाएगा उस टाइम।
अच्छा आप फ्री नहीं है?
नो सर।
ओके
सर वी कैन हैव अ लेक्चर टुमारो आल्सो, वी कैन कंटिन्यू दिस टुमारो इफ देयर आर सम इंटरनेट इश्यूज।
हाँ नो प्रॉब्लम, वी विल टेक योर क्लास टुमारो आल्सो, बट आई वाज थिंकिंग आज एक क्लास और हो जाता तो बढ़िया था। चलिए वी शैल टेक योर क्लास टुमारो। कल आप कितने कितने बजे फ्री हैं बताइए जरा एक बार। एट व्हाट टाइम यू आर फ्री ऑन टुमारो?
सर 1 to 2 will be a good
1 to 2 I will take your class, it is confirmed. After that in the evening are you free?
Sir evening the schedule is packed actually with different
okay,
lectures.
We shall take your class. I will take your class from 1 to 2.
Okay sir.
Acha ek aur baat hai, 2 to 3 bhi hamara ek lecture hai, the lecture is of group A, aap us time par bhi to free hoenge?
सर एक्चुअली 2 to 3 में ओएस की क्लास होती है जो कि स्केड्यूल्ड है वीक में 5 days रेगुलर क्लासेस।
अच्छा एक आप अभी मुझे इंद्रजीत सर का आया था फोन, बीच में आई जा रहा था बार बार कि उनका कोई क्लास है, वो आपका था या ए सेक्शन का था?
ए सेक्शन दैट इज विद ए सेक्शन।
ओके आप दोनों सेक्शन के जो सीआर है मिलकर के एक टाइम मुझे भी फिक्स कर दो 12 बजे। अनुष्का शायद सीआर है आपके या दूसरे सेक्शन में, इधर से आपके शायद अंकित था, तो उन्होंने मुझे 12 बजे का फिक्स करके बोला था कि सर 12 बजे डेली ले लिया करो क्लास।
यस सर 12 बजे डेली हम फिक्स है हमारा टाइम, बट एक इशू बस यही आती है कि जिस दिन एनवायरमेंटल स्टडीज की क्लास होती है तो ललित सर शायद थर्सडे फ्राइडे को क्लासेस लेते हैं, सो दैट्स व्हाई बस मैंने बोला कि कल 1 to 2 बिकॉज 12 बजे ईएस की क्लास शेड्यूल्ड है।
नहीं वो ठीक है, जिस दिन सर की क्लास हो आप उस दिन 1 बजे मुझे बता सकते हैं अर्ली में ही।
यस सर कल ही वो
बाकी दिन
एक
तो
बजे
12 बजे करिए ना, आज तो लेकिन थी नहीं क्लास ना 12 बजे, फिर इंद्रजीत सर का कैसे आ गया बीच में?
वो ए सेक्शन की शायद थी
पर इन्होंने
वो
फिक्स
लोग वहीं
करा हुआ
पे।
था पहले तो, पहले तो मुझे अंकित और अनुष्का ने पता करके, अंशिका शायद आपकी क्लास के सीआर हैं वो, आई डोंट नो
यस
व्हाई
सर
दिस इज गोइंग ऑन,
सर
है ना? आप एक बार बात करना है सीआर से बात करके ये फिक्स करो कुछ।
यस श्योर सर
ओके
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 सर
वी शैल टेक योर क्लास टुमारो 1 o'clock।
ओके सर
थैंक यू।